The other addition to New York Film Festival was Poor Things. It's one of the most anticipated and most raved about film in other film festivals, and we managed, well, I managed to get a chance to see it, and it is a ride. It's certainly a very extreme way of showing finding one's true self and being reborn and all of those amazing different concepts. Some parts land very well with me, and I think it's such an amazing way to showcase humanity and what it means to be human and how to learn all of those things. But some parts I think just were slightly overindulgent. Some of the scenes were unnecessarily there, I think. I think after they did multiple variations of those scenes, any more was a bit too much. I think the message was portrayed enough in one thing. For example, so the nudity and finding one's sexuality, I feel like maybe 4 or 5 scenes was enough, but I think they overdid it with that. But that's just my personal taste. Some people may find it perfect, and some people may enjoy to see that. But to me, I just didn't think it was necessary. So it did feel a bit bloviated a bit. But it was brilliantly acted out. Emma Stone knocked it out of the park. Willem Dafoe was perfect as well. I just thoroughly, thoroughly enjoyed myself with it. Mark Ruffalo was good. Sometimes he did phone it in a little bit, but I'm not sure if the character is supposed to be a little like caricature-y in some ways. I know it's based off a book, and I'm not sure how much of the book was actually relayed into the film, but it was a great film. It was really, really well made. I think it was, you know, a good time. Definitely, I definitely, and I'm reiterating this multiple times, I do think some parts of this film don't necessarily need to be, and it's definitely a rated R movie, so don't take your kids, I guess. But it's a really, really well made film. The set design is stunning. It's literally made, it's very practical, and they try to use as little CGI as possible, but it's very, very beautiful and very unique and very interesting in how they've made it. The costumes were absolutely impeccable. I thought a lot of the dresses that Emma Stone's character wore, I would try to pull it off, but honestly, they were really, really beautiful as well. The score also mimicked a lot of the really interesting and very complex parts of the film as well. A lot of the character build-ups and the dangers that the character was going through. I think it was just a perfectly made movie. My personal gripes with it knock it down just a little bit, but I think it's a great movie to at least watch once and to take away from the messages of, like, finding oneself as an adult, understanding evil and good and malevolence and benevolence as well. It's all of those in one, and finding the grey and the black and the white, and being able to come to terms with the existence of all of those things together. So I genuinely think that this film portrays all of those elements really well, and it's also quite a feminist movie in its own way. So I think it's a great addition to the film festival. It's a 4.5 out of 5. The reason for my rating is just because the overindulgence in certain types of scenes did feel like it took me out personally, but I feel like with other people, I think that it's perfectly fine. So I don't know, if you, it may bog it down for you, it may make it even better for you. Everyone has their own opinions on this. For me, it did slightly like take me out of it a bit and made me feel like, God, again, like, I think it was unnecessary, and in some ways lost its okay, I understood that I don't need to be force-fed multiple scenes of this. I don't want to spoil this. All my reviews are spoiler-free, so I can't really go further into this. Let me know how you guys find it. I still think it's an amazing film, regardless of my personal gripes with it. Let me know how you guys find it when you do get around to watching it. Till next time.